Welcome to the video. My name is Sayed. This video is about what is SAP and a brief introduction about ERP system and some information about SAP. My name is Sayed Awais Rizvi. I've been working in SAP industry for quite some time. I have written some SAP books. They are available on Amazon. The links will be in the YouTube description. So let's talk about what is SAP. So SAP stands for System Application Product and Data Processing. SAP is a name of a company. It is based off of Germany. And it is mostly famous for ERP system globally. Fortune 500 companies have mostly 90% of them have SAP system to do their business, sales, accounting, procurement, all different applications. So SAP is an ERP system. So what is ERP? ERP stands for Enterprise Resource Planning. So E for enterprise. So in enterprise, we can see that the enterprise represent organization, corporations, company. So that is basically enterprise resources. So in any company or any organization, they have logistics, where they have plants, inventory, distribution centers, they have employees, they have finance, where they have different functions of finance. So all of those resources are also go for plannings. For example, they do planning for inventory, they do warehouse planning, they do human resource planning. So basically all of those aspects are managed. Are basically called ERP. So SAP is an ERP system where it handles enterprise related information, logistics information, employees, human resource. So there must be different applications. So SAP have different applications. For example, any enterprise have three major areas or four: finance, logistics, human resource. So these are the these three are the main areas. As we can see on the right hand side is SAP Easy Access menu, where we can see it's showing that this is a main screen where we can see the logistics and we can see accounting. For example, in accounting we can see finance, financial accounting, supply chain management. So there are different aspects in accounting available in SAP, and they all will be called a different modules. So let's go to the next slide. So in this slide we can see there SAP is a R3 system. So currently we have SAP ECC, now we have SAP S/4HANA as well, but still R3 is in the market. And so R3 stand for three-tier system. So we can call three tiers into one: database server, application server, and third is a presentation, which is GUI or any phone or web browser, where you can log on to SAP and access the presentation server. So these three tiers represent R3 system. And so application, presentation, and database. So let's take a look at the application server. For example, application server connect to the database server, and now it connect to the laptop or mobile device or RF device to connect to the application server. So this, the circle of three application get connected through application server, where it have database servers in the background and it connect to the application. So basically it's just a representation in the mind map to understand it much more better and easy to understand. So now SAP have a latest version called SAP S/4HANA. So it is cloud-based, so it have a different flavors. So it is could be a purely cloud-based, could be a hybrid system where it have some cloud and some on-premise. It could be a on-premise system only. And so what is new about S/4HANA is it is in-memory computing, and the database technology is improved to the column base, and there are a lot of more improvements in the S/4HANA. It's much more faster, it's much more easier compared to ECC. So there are some advantages we have in SAP S/4HANA and compared to SAP ECC. So the S/4HANA is the latest version, and SAP R3 system is still being used, but it's not been discontinued yet. So at SAP have different modules, as we were talking about. Different modules represent different departments. For example, FICO represent finance and controlling. Logistic execution represent one of the modules. Warehouse management is one of the modules. Sales and distribution is one of the modules. So if you see SAP SD, so that is representing sales and distribution. If you see SAP FICO is representing FICO, finance and controlling. So the proper way of pronouncing the name of SAP is SAP, it's not SAP. If you say SAP is inappropriate, I would say it's SAP is much more more accepted and more being used. So in SAP FICO, we can see that what does it represent? We can see the SAP Easy Access Screen. SAP FICO stands for finance and controlling. Technically, it is two modules, and we can see this is a financial accounting and controlling. So basically, each folder is representing one module. So sales and distribution is one of the module as well. We can see that it is coming under logistics and sales and distribution. So SAP SD representing sales and distributions. It is sales related activities. It is one of the areas where we have order to cash cycle, starting from order all the way to the cash. Pre-sales activities, contracts, sales orders, shipments, billing. So these are the just high level overview of the what module. And what is the purpose of having SAP ERP system and SAP to handle different departments and different applications in system, so that they can track and do reporting and do their functions in this sales, procurement, or human resource, and all of the different enterprise aspects. So that's it for this video. Please like, subscribe, let us know how do you like the video. Thank you very much.